welcome to the AfriMind interview series. My name is Sakina, and today we'll be interviewing Nzube Ufodike from Amu Venture Capital Advisory. He is the director of Amu, and the company started in 2009. Today, it's growing really rapidly, and we'd like to find out more about what they think about venture capital in general and technology space, both in emerging markets and in Europe. Hope you enjoy. What do you think the role of venture capital is in Africa today, and how is it driving innovation and economic growth?
Venture capital in Africa is an industry that needs to be developed further. Unfortunately, there's not enough VC activity, nor VC players in Africa right now. As a driver for growth, generally, so in places like the United States or in Europe, you've seen them investing in early stage companies, which by default, they have obviously rapid growth rates that employ a lot of people, drive innovation, and help secure a lot of capital for industries that would otherwise be unable to get off the ground. So these are the benefits that that can be seen across other parts of the world. But in Africa currently, there are not too many players. There are more private equity participants, and there's little going on in the venture capital space.
Okay, and what do you think could be done to encourage more activity in the venture capital space?
That question is above my pay grade, but I think it should begin with more government support. So on a sovereign level, or state level, we should have the policymakers create environments that are more supportive of early stage investments and early stage risks that are being taken, because obviously most companies that are invested in, or most companies that are started, don't succeed. Mm-hmm. That's a fact across the globe. So Africa would not be any different. If these policymakers are able to create a more supporting tax structure for early stage investors, for instance, or help them by deferring certain tax obligations against losses, those would help, to get more people to invest in early stage businesses.
Okay. And you have seen the venture capital space evolve within, mm-hmm. From your beginning till today. How has your advisory strategy evolved as well to suit the current economy and the exit environment?
We've initially started with a focus on the developed markets, mm-hmm. but given that economy is shrinking and less capital is playing in these markets, we've shifted to the more emerging growth markets, where even though it is challenging to raise capital, there is some interest. Places like Brazil, Russia, India, China, South Africa, obviously, but other emerging markets that have a lot of tailwind in terms of just positive momentum behind them, that made us look more to emerging markets a little, because it's almost as if we're pushing in an open door.
Okay. And do you see any change in the relationship between venture capitals and startup firms over the next few years in emerging markets especially?
With emerging markets, due to the lack of execution experience, you tend to have VCs play a more integral role to development. So they do a lot more handholding. They tend to work with management teams a lot more closely. I see that trend continuing a lot more than it would here. Trends here that may or may not translate to emerging markets include alternative sources to funding, things like crowdfunding platforms that allow individuals to source capital from a group of individuals as opposed to just individual VC funds. That could probably be an interesting option.